like Joey Tanner. Big spender, Kris Jenner, I promote the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo, she like, oh, it's happening. Think she call me, think she, cause she never knew her daddy. And my all black, Rhythm Nation, Janet, boy, don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, was underground, was underground. Frontin' like a ride with the mob, why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I? Play the odds, a yes man, it's just a head.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at newly named State Farm Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. It's certainly hot outside here in the desert, but somehow this Cardinal crowd turned up heat a moment ago. They were in a frenzy as their team emerged from the tunnel, and the Cardinals, they're set to do battle with Derek Carr and the Oakland Raiders. And that'll carry over the back out of the end zone for a touchback. Now the first carry for Marshawn Lynch, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Carr to throw after the play fake to Lynch. Lets it go. He's got a man. Complete. 30. 20. 10. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Jordy Nelson, 74 yards. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Carlson now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Rosen and the Cardinals take over with a first and 10 at their own 23. On first down, it's Rosen underneath for Johnson. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. From the gun, it's Rosen. He's going to launch this thing way downfield into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Gilchrist. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. And look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up two touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Now Carr throwing on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
It's caught, Nelson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. First down, Raiders. The former Packer, Jordy Nelson, on the receiving end from Carr.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, doubt, find your veterans.
He used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
On second down, Lynch. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. He lost two there, and it's third down. Now, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Connects it to Roberts, right side. And down inside the 15 he goes. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down.
Did you see that route the way that I did? Yep. I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not to, it came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
On first down, Carr. Got an open man, it's Aitman. And they'll lose yardage here, knocked back to the 19-yard line. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. So they have the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football, but they face a second and long to start things out. Now a play fake, Carr, and he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25, Chandler Jones, in there to get him for a loss of five. Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a third and long. They fake the handoff, now Carr, under pressure again, and down he goes again. Hassan Reddick. In there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up fourth and long. The kick by Carlson is good, and the lead moves to 10-0. He's kicked. Now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding outs all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. This one complete to Christian Kirk, and they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. And this one complete to Jermaine Gresham. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely, great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Dumping it off for Johnson. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and it'll be a second down. Throwing again, it's Rosen. He's got it earlier in this first, but he bounces back with a touchdown pass.
And you have to like the mental acumen, the toughness, the fortitude of him, because oftentimes for a rookie, you throw an interception early, you're taken right out of the game, or mentally, you check out a little bit. Give him a lot of credit for bouncing back.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 22. They'll start on the ground with Lynch. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. Past the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Marshawn Lynch, 78 yards. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly for six. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slip through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Carlson now to kick this one away. This is TJ Logan to return it. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A good pickup there of 22. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now a play fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
While we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore, I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. On third down, Rosen. And he comes back with one complete. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What did the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open. He finds a way to pick up a first down.
Now Rosen on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. A gain of six there on first. Six yards was the pickup on the last complete, so here's second and four. Again, it's Rosen. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And on third and inches, we're going to get a whistle and a timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Rosen to throw on third down. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Now on fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
They're going on fourth down. Rosen. And an alley to run. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Now it's Rosen stepping up. He'll try and run. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this ball game. From the shotgun, it's Rosen. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. In for the score. And the Cardinals have cut it to within a score.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. The return man here, Dwayne Harris. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just seeing a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
They start the drive with Lynch. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Raiders out in front as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Raiders with the lead already, and they will get the football here as the second half is now underway. And an alley to run. He's at the 40, the 20, 10, touchdown, Cardinals. Pharaoh Cooper, 94 yards. And the Cardinals are in for six.
We've sat in a lot of meetings, and they always talk about the offense taking advantage of beginning a half. But special teams coaches don't listen to that. They want to take advantage with their own unit, and they just did.
Yeah, they trailed in the locker rooms, and they changed that immediately.
I think they drew that one up special. That felt like something he pulled out of his pocket that he's been holding for a while, and they were able to use it effective.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Third quarter starts with a run from Lynch. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They'll run to Marshawn Lynch, and he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs. First down, the run with Lynch. And now running right through it. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it second and 14. Play action. Now it's Carr. Going up top. Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Off by David Amerson, and his guys are get the
four down.
After the interception, here's Rosen, and down he goes, brought down, a Raider sack. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well, and that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great, but it was real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Fitzgerald bringing it in over the middle. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. He's got a man. It's Williams. And they get him down, but not before he gets it across the 40-yard line. The conversion is successful with a sizable gain of 13, and the decision to go for it looks like a smart one. Spinning past him, finding a safety valve here. That's complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
A first down carry here for Johnson. Finding room to the 20. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. David Johnson, 33 yards. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. The Raider offense now making their way toward the huddle. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Let's it go for Nelson. That's caught inside the 20. Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale. It's Raider football here, but they're on the short side of the scoreboard right now as we begin the fourth. Line of scrimmage, move their own 25 all the way to the red zone now for first and 10. They go play action here on first down. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you half all your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
On first down, it's Rosen underneath for Johnson. Oh, and this is going to wind up a safety. After the safety, remember, they also need to give up the football, and here's the free kick. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time will take a rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that,
and he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by David Amerson. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
Rosen and the Cardinals take over. A first and 10 at their own 21. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. Second down. Got to figure now, after getting the turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and a good chance of ending this game.
That one goes for 24 yards. They're looking to put the game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Escaping the pressure right. And that's caught inside the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big 30-yard play on third. So now then, the big has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They go back to the ground with Johnson. Might have gotten this down to the 28, and that's all. Arden Key, the ex-LSU Tiger, there on the stop.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Now whistles, and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. There'll be two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? Give him 5 yards there, and it'll bring up second down. The ball gets bumped up. It's now second and 4 after the penalty. Following the penalty, it's Johnson. And a short gain here, down to the 22. Now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more, plus the 2-minute warning, and we'll be back. From the gun on third down, it's Rosen. And this is going to be incomplete.
Now, he's been a busy man out of the backfield. They've looked his way quite a bit so far in this game.
Nice job there defensively, though, adjusting, because a couple of his earlier catches, he was wide open. Not that time.
You mentioned the key word, adjustment. A better cover man now in space.
So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it's still 8 up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, you get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. And he just clocked it, but the clock wasn't even moving. Well, that's one you don't see very often, a wasted down. On second down, here's Carr. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off near the 26. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. They'll hand it off now, Johnson. It's a gain of 11 yards at the minute, Purdue.
Get him behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they will take a knee here. One final kneel here as it comes inside the 42nd mark, and that should be enough to put this one on ice.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it, so it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
Well, I know at points in this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard, you're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Cardinals as we say so long from Glendale.